Okay, we lost 473,000 jobs last month. The U6 unemployment rate is now 16.8%. I'm going to talk about the Air France plane that crashed. I'm going to talk about a commentary called Disposable Marriage. I'm going to talk about the real estate market and these new homeowners. If I meet more than you're right, I guess you're right. If I wake up in your mind. July 2nd, 2009. I'm Demcat, also known as Reginald First. ADP is estimating that the private companies in the United States of America cut 473,000 jobs last month. some people are trying to spin this as a positive. I don't see the positive in this. It's ridiculous to try to pretend like things are getting better. Unemployment is crept up to 9.5%. It's the highest since August 1983. The number of people who filed for unemployment benefits fell in line with the forecast, so it wasn't lower than expected or higher, but it's just pretty much what the experts expected. We've lost 6.5 million jobs since this recession has begun, and it's been the biggest drop since, well, World War II. I mean, since the last Depression, basically. We haven't seen anything quite like this since the Depression. The U6 unemployment. Like I said, the official unemployment rate is 9.5, but if you calculate all the discouraged workers, people who stopped looking for jobs, people who are working part-time, who want to work full-time, people who had full-time, who are now working part-time just to get by, the real unemployment rate, or a more accurate measurement of the unemployment rate, is a U6, and that is 16.8%. It's getting up there. Here's some good news, though. U.S. factory orders actually rose 0.9% last month, and a month before it rose 0.7%. So we're seeing some increases, at least in demand for computers, airplanes, machinery, things like that. So there is some good news. Here's a really good article. It's called The New Homeowner Hallucination. Quote, we'll rent for a year and then sell when the market comes up. Well, comes back. Mark Hansen of the Field Check Group believes that there's a new segment of the market that is just waiting to crash. It's the middle to high-end residential real estate. Basically, people are coming in and trying to take advantage of these low prices, buying these better houses. Kind of like they did before during the bubble. I mean, it's kind of weird, you know. People didn't learn their lesson. Anyway, they're coming in. They're gonna try to basically buy this house and wait until the market goes back up because people are expecting a rebound. They're expecting a comeback. And this guy says that basically these people are dreaming, and I couldn't agree more. I think these people are crazy. When people lose their jobs, they lose their income. When they lose their income, they're not able to pay the mortgage. If they can't pay the mortgage, they lose their house. As more people lose their houses, the supply for houses will increase, but the demand will decrease because people don't actually have the money. You know, sure, people are going to want to live in houses, but they won't actually have the money to actually pay for the house. You're going to have more houses than you really need. So when that happens, the value of your house will decrease. So you can't have a rebound in the housing market if people don't have jobs. If people are losing jobs, you're not going to have a rebound in the housing market. It makes no sense. Air France plane crash intact. This is a really bizarre story. 229 people died. This plane apparently just went down. It went straight down. According to this expert, you can read it in an article, the plane basically, it was intact and it went down really, really fast. And then it came apart on impact. They still don't know what really happened. This is a really bizarre story. I think there's something that the officials aren't telling us. Something's shady. Anyway, here's a commentary. I found this on CNN. And it's called Let's End Disposable Marriage. Basically, this guy, Tommy, died. And he was a judge. He was Stanford educated. I think he went to a naval academy. really smart guy, and he was a judge, and he believed that one of the biggest problems in our society was a breakdown of the family and the fatherlessness. And, you know, as much as I rail against marriage, I agree with him on that point. He seems to believe that unintentional wedlock, childbearing, and the ease in which people get a divorce is really ruining our culture. I just think marriage is a bad idea overall. I mean, for men. I mean, if I was advising a woman, I would definitely recommend a woman get married. In fact, get married to a man with some money. I mean, actually, but maybe that's part of the problem, that mentality. But look, I think the family is breaking down and there's just no going back. Marriage simply isn't working because there's no incentive to stay involved in a marriage when you can get out so easily. Bottom line, he's a social conservative, it sounds like. And I just think that there's no turning back. This society, the family, is definitely going to break down. I mean, this whole idea that a man's going to be there for his kids and all that stuff, it's going way out the window. I know there's still some good fathers out there, but I think we're seeing more than an economic meltdown. Let me put it that way. Anyway, thank you for watching my videos. I really appreciate the support. Please comment. Tell me what you think. All right. Bye.